Well, welcome to Spokane Veterans Memorial Arena. You've had to wait all winter for this. The Spokane Shock, their home season about to get underway. Welcome inside as the fans filtering through the turnstiles. It is great to see everyone again. Greg Heister and Mike Peterson, the Arizona Rattlers. And Mike, this has turned into one of the better rivalries that the AFL has.
Oh, this is an epic early season game, Greg. You gotta love it. Rivalry, West Division, that has been the road to the Arena Bowl three straight years. This is heated.
And the schedule makers have done Spokane no favorites or favors. Five of their first seven games on the road, but their first three they did okay.
They did just fine, all three on the road. I don't care who you play. You go on the road three consecutive times, come away 3-0, you're the real deal. Arizona, tough schedule as well, facing the number two team three straight times, number four tonight.
It's a battle of the unbeatens tonight. Eric Meyer, we had hoped to see him a full season a year ago. The concussion cut his season short, but now we're seeing what this guy can do.
Phenomenal play by Eric Meyer. About as perfect quarterback play as you can see. Right now, if they had to vote, he's the league MVP, and he's the league comeback player of the year, but we got a lot to play here. But he has just been on fire. This offense has been unstoppable, and especially in the red zone this year, and a lot of that's attributed to Eric Meyer.
And he's got weapons. The big Adrian Tennell is back.
Tennell, record-breaking season last year for the Spokane Shock, broke all the franchise records. Out of the blocks, he's doing it the same. And 10 touchdowns so far this season. That's on track to go 60. That would just crush records. Big target. When you get him in the red zone, that tall frame, easy target, that leads to touchdowns.
Nick Davila, a former Spokane Shock player. That seems like years and years and years ago. Well, it kind of was, wasn't it?
It was, and wherever he's been, whether it's in a Shock uniform, now in a Rattlers uniform, this guy is lights out. 2011, he was AFL Player of the Year. Last year, won a ring like he did when he was here in Spokane, leading them to the Arena Bowl, and he was MVP of that game. Just has the full package.
Ladies and gentlemen, the two best teams in the Western Division. Arizona on the road to play Spokane. We'll get you tonight's starting lineups and the kickoff when we come back.
Championship football is back as your Arizona Rattlers get ready for the 2013 season. Season tickets start at just $5 a game. Get yours today and be entered to win a trip to the 2013 Arena Bowl. Call 602-514-TV-TV today.
91st Avenue, just north of Bell. Peoria Key is going to treat you well. Save some time and shop online. It's all right here at Peoria Kia.
Right now, drive away in a 2013 Optima LX for just $199 per month, or the 2013 Kia Soul for just $199 per month. Stop by Peoria Kia today or visit PeoriaKia.com. Service, selection, and save.
It's all right here at Peoria Kia.
Visit PeoriaKia.com.
Ultrastar Multitainment Center, where kids are the stars.
Well, here's that third down play a moment ago, as Spencer is going to line up a 19-yard field goal.
And just two drops in a row. Yeah. That's just a lack of concentration. I mean, what can you do? Two straight drops.
Tunnell was expecting a deflection as Spencer's kick from 19 yards is up and good. And, Mike, that's a critical kick for Spencer. 4 of 7 last year, and he's coming off a rough game.
Yes, last week, Spencer missed 4 consecutive PATs. Very concerning, but they worked all week getting the placement down. This is last week on 4 consecutive kicks. This is not the Kenny Spencer you're used to watching. And he pushed it right, and then he hooked it left, and then he hits the upright, and then he misses again. 4 missed PATs last week, but that was clutch coming through, getting that field goal.
Spencer from 19 yards out makes it a 2-possession game, 59-49, but a minute 16. Arizona's going to get the ball here. We've seen Nick Davila, when he's got it going, he's as good a deep ball thrower as you will see in the AFL, which means he can strike quickly.
Well, and let's flash back to last year's Arena Bowl run. Arizona's playing Utah. Similar situation, about a minute to go. They're down 2 possessions. Arizona comes storming back, beats Utah, ends up winning the Arena Bowl. Arizona was almost out of the playoff hunt, and they had that miraculous comeback in the playoffs. So, veteran team, they know how to do it.
Virgil Gray, number 4, back to receive the kick from Kenny Spencer. It's a high kick. It'll find the screen. Weird hop. Gray's got to cover it up and does. Touchback. I couldn't tell. Did that hit metal? It had to have hit metal, but it bounced to the right.
It looked like it grazed the right side of the metal and just shot off to the right side at a very awkward angle. Arizona dodged one there. Anytime that ball hits the metal, typically advantage of the kickoff team. Looks like it just grazed the metal. And that was a really strange angle that ball came off at.
Yeah, it did. All right. Ball's at the 2-yard line.
And on a kickoff, as soon as the ball hits the dashboard in the end zone, dead ball.
Arizona has 3 timeouts.
1 minute warning. Spokane leading Arizona 59-49 with a minute to play. First place in the West Division at stake. Nick Davila's football when we come back.
91st Avenue, just north of Bell. Peoria Kia's gonna treat you well. Save some time and shop online. It's all right here at Peoria Kia.
Right now, drive away in a 2013 Optima LX for just $199 per month. Or the 2013 Kia Soul for just $199 per month. Stop by Peoria Kia today or visit PeoriaKia.com. Service, selection, and save.
It's all right here at Peoria Kia.
Visit PeoriaKia.com.
Ever since I was a kid, I've had questions about how things work.
What's the speed of gravity?
Ooh, can I find a diamond in my backyard?
I love to experiment.
So I became a STEM road warrior, exploring and documenting my discoveries. This is my story. I'll share it with you every week on the STEM Journals.
Watch Sunday at 7 or 9 p.m. on Cox 7.
Championship football is back as your Arizona Rattlers get ready for the 2013 season. Season tickets start at just $5 a game. Get yours today and be entered to win a trip to the 2013 Arena Bowl. Call 602-514-TD-TD today.
Here's what's at stake. Arizona in the coaches poll, number 1. Spokane, number 2. That'll flip-flop if Spokane can finish this game. Here's Davila. Incomplete. Intended for Windsor.
Stops the clock with 55.3.
And even that throw there, Davila not under pressure, but his footwork just looks a little off, and he's just not as accurate as what we've seen. He's 4 on his last 11 passes down the stretch. That's concerning if you're Kevin Guy. And there's head coach Kevin Guy right there. AF2 Hall of Famer, got a ring last year. Been around this game a long time.
Again, another short pass. This one is dropped by Jared Perry, and Davila was dropped as well. It'll be third down from the 2-yard line.
Double jeopardy for Davila. You miss with the throw, and that's on you. You come back with the throw on the money, and the receiver drops a perfectly thrown ball.
I think you got to throw some downfield, though. These little dink and dunk passes. Throw it downfield. Let your athletes go get the football, Mike. Perry in motion. Davila steps up, away, and it's caught. You see what I mean? By Jared Perry.
And we have an injury down here, Greg.
Shock player, 33-yard gain, and that's Williams, number 72. Jonathan's had a great game for Spokane, in my opinion. An early penalty.
And he's apparently in a lot of pain down there, Greg.
He is. Couldn't, South Carolina.
Couldn't
played
really
for the old ball coach.
Tell what happened, but it's, you're there against the dasher boards, you can get rolled off.
Well, they're pinching his back, his lower back.
You can get rolled awkward into that dasher board at times.
Could be a compression injury. If he went in head first or something into that dasher board.
And we've certainly seen that. And as they're tending to him, we'll just go back to that throw. That another big play for Davila. And this is going to come down to if Arizona scores. Obviously, Arizona has to go for the onside kick.
Take another look. Look at the right corner of your screen. Williams trying to get in there. Oh, okay.
Just got
hit by his own player.
We see that. Two edge guys coming to each other. You get hit, and that's that ends up being a little bit of a spine compression, lower back.
That is a big dude. Arizona with 5 plays over 30 yards in this game. 46 seconds to play. Davila's got his team at the 15-yard line, first down and 10. Arizona wants to score quickly, and then they go for the onside kick.
5 plays over 30, that's not containing the big play.
No. Far side, Windsor, wide open over there. Again, a pass that curls Windsor back around where he catches it and turn up field might get him in the end zone.
It may.
He's 220 pounds. There's not many DBs in the league that's going to stop him with a head of steam.
Oh, no, he is a big, big load of a wide receiver after he gets the ball. As we saw when Stevens bounced off of him on the catch and run. Plenty of time for Arizona, though.
Sure there is. Second down and 2 from the 7. Davila with time, picked off over the middle. What a catch by Bo Bell. And that'll be the ball game. Bell went 10 feet into the air to catch that. And it looks like Patrick Stoudemire is on the field. He's hurt for Spokane.
Very athletic play by Bo Bell. And the crowd, very appreciative. I mean, he went high.
Just the 3rd interception of the year by Davila. And
Stevens
the 6th turnover forced by this Shock defense, and none bigger in this season. That was actually James Ruffin, I believe, that was down.
And James Ruffin is up.
And Ruffin is up.
And as long, all Spokane needs is positive yardage plays.
Oh, that catch by Bell.
Oh, my goodness.
Just watching the eyes of Davila.
And leaping high in the air.
That's a championship-winning play right there, 4 games into the season. What a start by the Shock. They're going to get to 4-0, and they win their first three on the road. The end of the season is going to be home heavy on the schedule.
Yeah. Well, and if we go to the Keys, Spokane, you get three stops, you get a win. That's number three.
Now, Arizona still with three timeouts left, so this is not a gimme as far as draining the clock all the way down. Meyer just keeps it. And he's ahead to about the 24-yard line. And Arizona using a timeout. We'll get three straight plays like this. Well, maybe not. I mean, Spokane's got to try to pick up the first down to ice the game completely.
Well, and then what's going to happen? So you've got a first down play. Then you would have the second down play. Then the third down play and another timeout.
Right.
Then you run your fourth down play, and if you get stopped and you go get a first down, Arizona's got the ball. Now, at that point, can you make up two possessions? Probably not.
See, that's why I think if you're Andy Olsen, you got to stay aggressive. Play to pick up a first down. You win the game. You got to play. There's still a chance to lose this.
So what I would say, given that, is run three times, burn all the timeouts, and then pass on fourth down.
Mike, I say pass right now and get the first down and ice the game. You've got to stay aggressive. If you lose the game being aggressive, you lost trying to win. Right now, I don't know. These sorts of situations drive me crazy.
Well, it's a two-possession game. Now, one-possession game, I agree. But, again, we have a two-possession game. You're going to have about 4 seconds per play. So look at the clock, 16 seconds, and then Spokane will run a fourth down play. Now, assuming Spokane doesn't make it, that means Arizona would get the ball with about 12 seconds to go, so Arizona would have to score in one play, recover an onside kick, and kick a field goal. It's in the realm of possibility, but as I just do the mental math, I say run three times, and then on fourth down, try to ISO with the first.
I understand what the conservative history tells you to do in these situations. I'm just saying we saw this not work at the end of the first half, and Spokane, it could have cost them the football game not getting points there. This is the same situation. I think you got to give Eric Meyer, who has not thrown an interception all season, a chance to win this game for you right now.
That's a valid point.
Pick up a first down, game is over.
The hottest quarterback in the league, and you have a valid point there as well. Let's put it this way. Spokane has some nice options right now.
He's going to throw it here on third down. And they get a flag. That's offsides. Free play. End zone. Tannehill's got it. Touchdown, Spokane.
And Greg Heister is happy. You called it, buddy.
I am happy. Stay aggressive. Win the game. I think that's the eighth touchdown of the game by Meyer.
And Arizona was offsides, so this will stand.
Tannehill made up for it on that play. Two spectacular catches by Adrian Tannehill in the end zone in this fourth quarter.
And I might add,
muscles the defensive back.
Talk about closing out a game. Three straight scores by Spokane to close this game out.
And now you beat Arizona by three scores, and the ripples that go across the AFL go across nationwide. Not only now are you number one in the coaches poll next week, but you get all the votes.
Oh, yes, you do. Except the one you can't cast for yourself.
Right. Meyer should celebrate.
And I certainly would, because he's also player of the game. 27 for 41, 356 yards, 8 TD passes and runs for one. Very easy pick for player of the game. Those kind of numbers, he's on line for player of the week.
Yeah, and he is our Wendell Ford Nissan and Infinity player of the game. And watch these dimes. How many touchdowns now in the season? I think he came in with 24. He's got, 32 now?
Eight today.
And zero interceptions.
And I believe two rushing touchdowns on top of it. Remarkable.
Yeah, one in this game. He's got three on the season, I believe, now. And Tannehill, 11 catches, 141 yards, his four touchdowns. But Eric Meyer right now looking like the early leader in the clubhouse for player of the year in the AFL.
man. That's the man.
He's just happy to be playing, I think.
Yeah, well, and comeback player of the year. We saw that hit as we flash back to last year. The mooring headhunting shot on Meyer, that could have easily ended his career. And it does not look like he's missing a beat.
Oh, what a difference a year makes.
Oh, those fans are getting a lot of footballs. They're liking Kenny Spencer tonight.
Certainly are. They're asking, can we keep one? Can we just keep one? They're telling them five so they're keeping count. So I wonder, we got to ask somebody so we have these facts during our next broadcast. What do these fans get for turning that ball in?
They've got to get something.
Right? I mean, I'd want to keep one of them.
Oh, yeah, those balls are cool.
Yeah. 66-49, Mike.
You know, look at the Spokane defenses. 40, only 49 points given up tonight. This is the number one scoring offense in AFL with Arizona.
They're not going to stop the clock because they have no timeout. Oh, they did have one timeout left. Arizona concedes. And Spokane wins at 66-49. They're now a perfect 4-0 to start this season. And all four wins by double digits, meaning at least two scores. It's impressive the way Spokane has started this season.
This is as strong a start as Spokane has ever had. They go on the road three straight. They've proven they're road worthy, certainly proven they're home worthy, and certainly worthy of beating the best in the AFL and the defending Arena Bowl champ. Impressive all the way around, Greg.
And I'm most impressed with Eric Meyer. Obviously, the key to football is the quarterback, whether it's indoor or outdoor. If you don't have a championship caliber quarterback, your chances of winning diminish, especially in the indoor league. You've got to have that position sewed up. And Eric Meyer right now playing as well as anybody in the game.
Everyone knew, no one ever questioned Eric Meyer was that elite athlete and that elite talent. But now that he's healthy and really showing what he can do, his question was the durability. If he maintains this, all those tools are on display. Spokane is a team to reckon with at this early stage in the season.
And I tell you, Meyer took some shots in this game, but he was able to stand in there strong and throw, what, 8 touchdown passes, run for another, and lead his team here in the fourth quarter and come up with the big play to wrap it up. And Andy Olson, now in his second season as the head coach of the Spokane Shock, has his team off to a 4-0 start. The first three of those wins on the road, and the Shock are off and running. They own first place right now in the West Division. They're 4-0, and they just beat the defending champions. Ladies and gentlemen, for Mike Peterson, I'm Greg Heister. Good night from Spokane Veterans Memorial Arena. The Shock are 4-0.